Several broken barrels lay scattered here. Someone or something discovered the materials. Tracks lead into the woods and a nearby cave. Two troll camps sit back in the jungle brush. Tracks run through a well. Vargo Bodybreaker is dead. You have slain a mercenary lieutenant. More broken barrels and tracks lead directly into the cave ahead. Troll tracks. Trolls have... You descend into a still cavern, smelling stagnant water and decay. Mushrooms line the floors, and their spores hang in the unpleasant air. Ahead, rust monsters consume iron bands and seals from the wooden cylinders scattered on the floor. The troll tracks end at a pool of tepid, murky water. You can only reason that the trolls swam from this point. Brackish water runs off your face, a stench permeating your clothes. Or is that the stench of trolls ahead? Mushrooms have grown large and thick enough along the walls to provide a walkway down to the lower level. More stashes may be there. Rust monsters huddled ahead appear to be the trolls' pets. It is unlikely that you can find a way out of the pit without going through them. You have collected 8 cylinders hidden by House Fjarlan. You must now use them on House Thorani's supplies. Giant ruins extend into the jungle. The overgrowth is so thick that you cannot see where they end. This must be where Gwilyn fought to hold off the hobgoblins. Jarlbur is dead. You have slain a mercenary lieutenant. An archway looms before a series of connected ruins. Patrols of hobgoblins and ogres defend the archway and bar the way into Gwilym's stand. The stonework path splits in three directions ahead. The sound of hooves and jingling chainmail echoes off the ruined walls. You hear the sound of wood being dragged across stone, along with a few muttered curses. It sounds like House Thorani is busily excavating the ruins. The ramp continues to a landing, before turning sharply and passing out of sight. Signs of patrols are evident everywhere as you descend. Your eyes sting as you pour the gray powder into the Thorani supply crates. Your eyes sting as you pour the gray powder into the Thorani supply crates. Oh. More supplies have been stowed beneath an outcropping down the stairs ahead. Still more are visible straight ahead on this landing. Suropox flips a slimy claw in your direction and growls at his troops, who begin to close on you. Suropox is dead. You have slain a mercenary lieutenant. Your eyes sting as you pour the gray powder into the Thorani supply crates. Your eyes sting as you pour the gray powder into the Thorani supply crates. Crippler Bigfoot commands his unit to form up and engage your force as you close on his position. Crippler Bigfoot has been defeated. You have slain a mercenary lieutenant. Defeated. You find that this supply site is well fortified. Reason dictates that this is the main site. Jared Mighty Hoof glares down at you and prepares to charge. Zarin Mighty-Hoof, the mercenary leader, is dead. Your eyes sting as you pour the gray powder into the Thorani supply crates. Your eyes sting as you pour the gray powder into the Thorani supply crates. Boxes containing essential House Thorani supplies line the walls of the ruins here. A squad of guards watches over the supplies. Another section of the ruins, overgrown by the jungle, features a set of stairs leading up a massive stone platform. A ramp extends into the earth here. Signs of travel lead into a massive archway covered in runes. A ramp continues down into the ruins. Guttural voices and light, airy voices of the elves reverberate from deep within the structure.
The Ardir Arafel prepares his elves for an assault against.
The Ardir Arafel, a ranger with House Thrani, falls dead. Manager grunts and lowers his head before bellowing a command to his troops.
Attack!
Maneater falls dead. He has slain a member of the mercenary company hired by House Thrani. Your eyes sting as you pour the gray powder into the Your eyes sting as you pour the gray powder into the Thrani supply crates.